Thank you. So, OpenIO, it's not a.
Non, parce que ça, c'est. Je suis pas sûr que ça soit formaté pour du Mac.
Ouais.
C'est du XT4.
Bon, ici.
C'est pas ça.
So, hi, so I'm Guillaume Delaporte. I'm a co-founder and product manager at OpenIO. So, we'll discover what is OpenIO. We are, I think, the freshest member of OW2. What is OpenIO? OpenIO is an open source object storage project. So we develop an open source object storage solution. So it's object storage is for small and for massive storage infrastructure. So I said it's we are new player in the market of object storage. I said new, but it's not really the truth because the initial concept and the design started in 2006. And we installed it in production for the first massive infrastructure in 2009. And we developed this solution in a big IT company, worldwide company, during 8 years since 2006. And in 2012, the project became open source to a project from a large French ESP, well known of the top of this Kakemono. And in 2014, we stored 10 petabyte of data with our project. And in 2015, all the development team left the company, and we forked the project. And now OpenIO is born. At the company was created in June, and we are fresh member now of OW2. And so we are seven co-founders. It's a development team. We work on the massive storage infrastructure since 8 years. So we are what we can say expert in storage infrastructure. Today, the solution work for 50 million of users, 10 petabytes, as I said previously, and OpenIO, so it's launched in 2015. So object storage is the right answer. It's a solution made for massive storage needs, so like email, cloud, big data. When you need to store a lot of data, you have something like a data warehouse, so you have a lot of data to store, and you have to retrieve it. So you need a data warehouse when you store your data, where you store your data, and it's a good solution to achieve that, and it's a good solution for telco, cloud providers, service provider. So everyone who need to store data and a lot of data and retrieve it needs this type of solution. It's a new type of storage solution. You can, as I said, store multiple petabytes of data in our solution with only one namespace. So very easy to use for developers because you have only one namespace, even if you store 10 gigabytes or 100 of petabytes. And it's, like I say, open source. And we are focused on performance and scalability. So it's open source. Here is our GitHub. Don't forget to start us at the end of this presentation. And our highlights. So the existing technology, we have existing technology like distributed file system with one single name node. Very interesting for when you need to store large file, but only few. Because when it's a file system, a distributed file system, but when you need to store, like we did about 10 billion of objects, you can store it in a file system. This technology are not good for this type of use case, and we have some competitors in object storage, open source, and they all work with hash table or consistent hashing. So they have a consistent hashing to address the data. So it's a good solution to store a lot of objects. But you calculate hash at the beginning of the project. So when you need to add new nodes, you have to recalculate this hashing, and you have to rebalance the data on the new nodes. So it's very impact on the it's impactful on your infrastructure when you add new nodes, because you have to rebalance a lot of data, and your server work for this rebalancing and not for the production. So we have a pragmatic design with three levels of indirection. So we have something like containers and chunks. So when you store data, we have a container who stores the location of objects, and but not storing the object. So even if you have 100 objects or 1,000 of billion objects, you will only have three hops, because we have a free level of indirection to retrieve your data. So it's very interesting for large and small infrastructure. So we have a grid of nodes. So we distribute even the directory and the data, and each node take part in the in the directory and in the data. So when you add new node, you expand your capacity, your storage capacity, and your directory capacity. So we have, of course, a non-spoof infrastructure. So when the node is down, other nodes we have a replication, all type of like erasure coding or things like that to secure your data inside the solution. Our main feature is conscience. So the conscience is a technology inside the OpenIO. Takes information on all their nodes on the infrastructure, compute scores. So the conscience can say at the t-time when you want to store a data, which is the best node to do that. So it's very performance oriented, because when you store data, you will put it on the best node of the infrastructure. So it's a clever load balancing as to select the best node at a t-time. So our references, because it's easier to explain what we do with an example. It's for a major French telco, well known major telco. So we store 8 petabytes of emails, and for 8 billion of email and attachment with very strict SLA, because email, when you read your email, you don't want to wait seconds for retrieve it. You want to read it now, and we have extended our solution, because when you store mail, you need to do a task on your mail, and like I say, the conscience can choose the best node at t-time to store data, and we extend the conscience, which is now able to choose the best node at the t-time to launch a task. So for this use case, we also store the mail and make things like mailbox cache with Redis. So when you open your webmail, you have the 10 last mail with an excerpt of each mail. So we cache this data on a distributed Redis on our infrastructure. Full text email indexation with Elasticsearch, the same thing. We distribute Elasticsearch inside our solution, so we can choose when you need to index a mail, the best node to index your mail at the t time, and thing like antivirus, and also a consumer cloud. In the use case, we store mail, and then the client asks us to store video and photo for consumer cloud. And we store also videos and photos for all consumer cloud of this customer. And we need to, for the video, for example, to transcode the video, to be able to read the video from TV, from Android, from iPhone. So when you when the client stores their data inside the solution, we launch a task in the best node to transcode the data. So why OpenIO? Because we are open source. But if we wasn't open source, we'll be not there today. So you can start from zero petabyte to 100 of petabytes. As I said, the conscience, you can put small increments of nodes. The conscience will learn from the infrastructure and know that there is a new node which is empty. So we'll put a little more data on it to make the infrastructure homogeneous naturally. So you no need to rebalance your data when you add a new node to put some data on it. The conscience will do the job for you. And you can, because when we make the previous use case, we have 600 of servers who store the data, but with a lot of CPU and RAM unused on this 600 server. So like I said, you can now launch apps to use all these elements on the server to run your apps or run tasks on the data you stored. So maybe it will be clearest for for someone. We are compliant with Amazon S3 and OpenStack Swift. So we have an implementation of S3 Gateway and OpenStack Swift Gateway. So we can use S3 client and OpenStack Swift client to store data inside our infrastructure. We have some native APIs, which is optimized and performance oriented in Python, Go, and C. And for a system engineer like me, a command line interface to store your data. So we are production ready, as I told you, because we have a lot of experience and the solution is mature. So we have some packages and automation tool to deploy it on production. But if you just want to try it today, we have a Vagrant box. So you just have to go to this URL and download a file, then a Vagrant app, and it will spawn a virtual machine on your servers with all the OpenIO inside. So if you want to meet me, we are in the OW2 village, so you can come to see us and take a beer at the beer party. We are expert in storage and also expert in beer event. So thank you.
And I would say you're also expert in design. You're a particularly successful design. Seriously, it's impressive and it's worth to be mentioned for open source, I think, because it's not so that usual. The big data session is about to start. I see Stefano there. I'm not sure if the others are here, so we have to speed up. Maybe we can postpone the one quick, yeah, and the others for the beer.
One quick question. I didn't understand if you are or you will provide online services.
But we actually work on the SaaS solution, SaaS offer to put online your data inside OpenIO. But today we are only a software developer, so you need to have your infrastructure. But we work on the SaaS offer. Stay tuned.